Good afternoon. Emergency services at the Worcestershire Acute Hospitals NHS Trust have been criticised in a report highlighting four breaches of its licence. Inspectors found safety and care concerns, including poor staffing levels and poorly maintained equipment. Our health correspondent Michele Paduano is at the Worcester Royal Hospital for us now. Michele, a damning report into services.
It is. It's highly unusual for breaches of this kind to be actually highlighted in this way. The key problem, of course, was those corridors with up to 24 patients on them and the fact that patients weren't being prioritised to be seen. But there are issues around things like resuscitation trolleys, which had old equipment on them. Then there are problems with sort of children's security and the fact that the management didn't seem to be listening to the problems that were taking place. Now, we spoke to a daughter of a man who died 4 weeks after the Care Quality Commission report came out, and she wants to see real changes taking place.
To see someone else have to go through that because of other people's mistakes or lack of training, whatever it is, it's horrible. We just want it to be improved. I mean, at some point we're all going to need that hospital, and if it stays as it is or gets worse, there's no hope for any of us.
So what is the Trust doing to put things right?
Well, it's already actually changed some beds from a clinical decisions unit, and that seems to have emptied the corridor. We went in today and witnessed the corridors were clear. They didn't have the signs up as they had done before. They've also got dedicated triage areas, which are there so that patients will be seen quickly, and they've also actually increased their staffing. The chief executive says there's more to do.
Obviously, it's out today. That was, you know, quite uncomfortable to read. Nevertheless, I think it was a call to arms. I think all of our staff have responded absolutely superbly. We've managed to make changes that have now cleared the corridor, and things are looking a lot better, but we know we've got more to do.
Well, they seem to be moving in the right direction, but the problem they have, this hospital is really built too small.
Michele Paduano, thank you. Well, patients who are failing to get treatment at the Worcestershire hospitals may be turning up at Birmingham's QE. 5 years after the super hospital opened its doors, it's running at maximum capacity. This year, patient figures will reach over 1 million over a 12-month period. And managers say it's feeling the strain. Catherine Stancheshan reports.
It was never the plan, but 170 beds in the old QE hospital are once again occupied. This is the link bridge between the old QE and the new hospital. It was only ever supposed to be temporary. It's now a permanent thoroughfare as numbers of patients have gone up and up. And now there's nowhere else to go.
To be honest, there's not any more of the old hospital that we can open up now. And I think the reality is that as a health and social system within Birmingham is that just simply opening more and more capacity in acute hospitals isn't the answer.
The QE's 5 years old today. Its trauma unit has been one of its biggest success stories, something that Matty Katerzebek knows all too well after a motorbike crash 8 weeks ago left him severely injured.
The team here done an excellent job. I had a fractured skull. I've got a few blades in my cheekbone, in my jaw, and obviously inside my upper jaw.
Some of the expertise that helped Matty was gained from their success treating injured soldiers. But it's not all rosy. The hospital has to save £60 million. It's full up. And bosses say a new plan is needed. Catherine Stancheshan, Midlands Today, Birmingham.
Well, joining us now is the chief executive of the Hospitals Trust, Dame Julie Moore. Dame Julie, your hospital isn't big enough, is it?
Well, it was 5 years ago. We've seen a rapid growth in demand coming from a variety of sources. We can do more treatments, but increasingly more and more patients want to come to us.
Well, when you see the news coming out of the Worcestershire Hospitals Trust today, you could ask some patients around Redditch area and they'd say, we'll just go to the QE. But in reality, do you need the hospitals around you to be secure, or could you cope if we all came to your A&E instead of Redditch?
No, we need all the hospitals to be fully successful, working very well. Our hospital was planned on the assumption that all the hospitals around us would continue working in the way they always have done. And when you see things like the Care Quality Commission going in and finding the hospitals not working well, then patients quite rightly decide to vote with their feet. And we've seen a massive influx of patients from all around us in recent years.
So you really wouldn't be in a situation to offer help to other hospitals that are failing?
Well, there's different ways of offering help, and in fact we've got a track record of going out and helping hospitals who've been failing for some time. And in fact I think we've helped four now by what the government calls buddying, going out and helping hospitals to get back on the right track. So we're always happy to do things like that. I think in Worcestershire we've had 4 years now of reviews and the situation continues to deteriorate, and for the patients who live in those areas I think it is quite a worrying time when we never seem to have a resolution to it.
We need it sorted out.
Yes.
Dame Julie Moore, thank you very much, and happy birthday to everyone at QE.
Thank you.